Hey everyone, welcome to Friday's special tip. And today we're going to look at how to make math notes step by step, right? There is a method to the madness, so make sure to stick to the end to see how it's done properly and an example of what it will look like. So what do we need to do first? Well, get a new plain exercise book, right? So you want a plain exercise book like this, right? I like these spiral notes because you can just fold them in like that. You don't have to fold it out. Very easy to work with. And you want a brand new one for maths, right? You're not gonna put every subject in one book, only maths in one book, and for every other subject, have its own book. Okay, so what's step two? I don't need this for now. Step two, so at the end of each week, you're gonna summarize everything you learned for maths. Now, what does that summary entail? So that's the main step, step three. So the first thing we're gonna do is any formulas. Okay, that's a given, right? You learn a topic, you got some formulas, you're gonna put those in there first. That's an obvious one. But what else are we gonna include? Any theorems, especially if you're doing geometry, you're gonna have heaps of those. So we're gonna include those in the summary. Next, step-by-step processes. Right, that's a big one. This is probably one of, I'd say, the most important thing you want in your summary. Now, I don't know if you've seen the videos on my channel, but especially on Mondays, I have step-by-step tutorials where I actually lay out step-by-step what you need to do. And why this is critical and the best thing you can do for your summary book is when you go for revision, for an exam, and you get to a particular question, you think, how do I do that? I'm not sure. If you just look at examples of working out, you're gonna think to yourself, what the hell did I do here? So by having a step-by-step process outlining what you do at each step, what you're going, oh yeah, okay, that's what I do, all right? That is probably the best thing you can do for your summary book. So what I teach my students is everything I do is step-by-step. I give it to them step-by-step. I don't just say, you gotta take the minus away, whatever. I don't dictate it. I get them to write down the step-by-step process because I know that is the best thing for them, right? When you go to IKEA, you get a furniture pack. Now those things are a nightmare to build. Imagine you didn't have a manual to build it step by step, okay? So having step by step guides or processes in writing makes life a lot easier, just instead of a visual, right? In words. So what I recommend you do is if you don't have these step by step guides, or most teachers don't do that, is try and write your own. Look at how something's done and try and dissect yourself, and that will actually increase your learning. So by being able to break down step by step what you're doing from that question, it will really help your learning. So this is critical. Make sure this is done for each type of question, or for all the moderate to hard ones. For basic stuff, I wouldn't worry, but for moderate to harder stuff, make sure you have a step by step process. So then what's next? Any special notes or tips? So these are separate to a step-by-step process. The step-by-step process tells you how you do each step, but sometimes there's gonna be some special tips or notes on the side that will help you. So you wanna add those in there as well, and you'll see that in the exampler. Next. So one more thing we need, one example max. All right, we're doing a summary book here, so we want it nice and concise. So if you're gonna have 50 examples, it's gonna look messy. So when you're doing a particular topic, one example for that. So it's great because you're gonna have a step-by-step process and you have one example showcasing how that works. So pretty much this is everything you wanna include in your summary for maths. And the last step, repeat weekly. So what does that mean? Just do rinse and repeat this every week, right? Well, you don't need to get a new book every week. You've already got a new book. So at the end of each school week, you're gonna summarize everything you learned in your exercise book. And this is what you're going to include. And definitely, just can't emphasize enough, if you don't have a step-by-step process, make sure you create your own. Or check out the videos on my channel, because especially my Monday tutorials, if there's a topic there, it will have a step-by-step process. So I have those on my channel because I know that's the best way, right? Having it in writing, what you have to do, makes life a whole lot easier. And you're gonna do that every week. So when it comes to exam time, everything's summarized neatly. And this, by perfecting this, when it comes to revision, or make revising for your exam a lot easier because you have everything there. This is really great for university as well. It doesn't have to just be for high school, especially university when you've got a ton of formulas, a ton of content. You have to be revising week by week, summarizing week by week, right? You've got a 13-week semester usually. So each week you need to be summarizing. So when it comes to mid-sems or finals, you have all your stuff summarized. So, because you've already got big finals you've got to study for. So if you've got to create a summary and study for your past papers and tutorials, good luck, okay? That's just too much to do. So this should be done every week, because if you do it every week, it's only gonna be like 5-10 minutes instead of having to do it all in one whole a few hours. And no one's gonna sit there a few hours summarizing. You're gonna quit, gonna go on Facebook, whatever. So make sure you do this weekly. So lastly, let's look at an example of what this will look like. Okay. So here's an example of, say you had to summarize trigonometry, right? So on Monday, I did a step-by-step tutorial on how to find sides and angles using Sakatoa. And here's an example of how you would summarize that in your summary book. So we've got our heading. So first off, we got our formulas. So we draw the diagram here, then the right angle triangle, labeling the sides opposite, adjacent, hypotenuse. Sine theta is opposite on hypotenuse, cos and tan. Then, here's a special note. We use Sakatoa to remember these formulas. So that's a special note. Then, finding side using trig. Here's our step-by-step process. So step 1, 2, and 3. And then here is one example to demonstrate how the process works. So you can see it's a really simple layout of how you should be summarizing your notes. And I recommend start doing it now. So if you haven't got a nice summary or a proper summary like this, start making one now, right? I know in New South Wales, we've got year 12's got half yearlies coming up. So really by now you should have had all your summary done, but I recommend getting this done now and then getting those parts papers. Okay, so if you enjoyed today's tutorial, make sure to give us a like and comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe and share this video with your friends so that they can make a proper summary for maths. Okay, so how to make math notes step by step, really straightforward, and I recommend you start doing it now.